Hi everyone, and welcome back, and thank you for joining me. Today I thought we'd do a little birch tree autumn sort of painting. The painting I did of the birch trees in the foreground and the forest in the background proved to be quite popular, so I thought I'd give another sort of version of that, except this is just birch trees or aspen. I don't really know the difference. They both look the same to me. With some, the last of, you know, autumn's leaves. So I have faintly drawn in my composition. You know, I have one tree here and another one here with a bit of a limb. So gives me sort of, you know, the rule of threes and fives, sort of gives me a three since I have a limb there, a branch or a limb, I guess. So I'm going to start off with some Winsor and Newton gouache. For our trees. So now I'm wetting my brush. I'm not going straight in with the gouache. Just a slightly wet brush, almost more damp than wet. And then our second tree here. Try not to make it perfectly straight. And then our limb. And there we have it. I don't know if you can pick that up, if the camera picks it up. Now, while that is slightly wet, I'm going to come in with Jane's Gray, which is a Daniel Smith gray. It's a little softer than Paynes gray. And I'm going to add some shadows. Don't want this too dark. Our light's coming from the left. Okay. I think we have it there. Okay, just a quick dry a little bit. Okay, that's pretty well dry. I'm coming in with my Micron 01 pen. And I'm going to slightly give an indication of the edge of our trees. Okay, and then I'm going to come in to do the markings that you'll find on these trees. Some areas darker than others. Okay. Now we want to come in with our branches. Now we don't want to do too many branches where the emphasis is going to be on our leaves. So I'm going to leave that like that for now because I want to start with our leaves. Okay. I think our composition's fairly even. A little bit of substance to our branches here. Now we're not going for realism. Now, let me see. What we can do is we can paint this in, and if we find we need a little bit more, we can always add to our, we can't take away. So I'm going to leave it at that for now. And I'm going to come in with my size 5 brush and try my new gold paint. And I think I'm going to mix it a little bit and add some sap green and Paynes gray. Let's see what I get. I'm going for a, an autumn sort of. Autumn leaves. Leaving some little white spots, because that always gives more interest to your watercolor, or I find. Okay, I think I'll try to come in with a touch more of the gold. Now this is Winsor Newton Artist Grade Gold. None of my, I use Winsor and Newton Student Grade paints, a larger palette. With 3, 6, 7, 8, 24 pans. And I use Daniel Smith, 12 pan, and M. Graham. So I didn't have gold in any one of those, so I ordered a separate gold from Winsor & Newton. Okay, we're going to try to add a little bit of gold here. Wet my brush a little bit. Okay. It's about right, I think. Now we're going to come in. I'm going to dry this for a second, and then we're going to come in with our pen and add some, a little bit of detail. Actually, before I do that, I might have done this first, and I'm feeling like it needs it. So I'm going to come in with a little bit of blue, a little bit of a light blue wash, and I'm going to use Cerulean Blue by Daniel Smith. Need a larger brush. Just a slight wash. I might have done this first. I don't know if I said that, but it's ever so light. I think I'll add a wee bit more. So a little bit darker at the top. You Yeah, this is a lot easier if you do it first. Okay, that'll do it. Okay, we need to dry that. Now, I'm wondering if I need a little bit more green in here. I'm going to try a little bit more green on a couple of the leaves. Now, that would be sap green and Paynes gray to give an olive green. Okay, let's try a little more green here. Yeah. And a tiny bit more because it seems to me that the tips will turn first. Oh, the sun's trying to come out. There, that's better. Yeah, like that much better. Okay, now we'll come in with some details. With our trusty old Micron pen. Making our branches a little darker, I think. Okay. A little more detail on our leaves. So I think we have it. Let's take our tape off. To try that just with the it's a small piece. We're going to try this with a mat, see how it would look. And that would be our little piece. Put your John Henry on there. And there you have it. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. I certainly love doing them. Would really love a thumbs up. If you like that, thumbs up. It's a little discouraging if you have, you know, a couple hundred views and two thumbs up. It. I mean, and if that's how you feel, if you don't want to give a thumbs up, that's fine. But it certainly gives encouragement to those of us that are out there doing these videos. So, yeah. So, I hope you enjoyed that. I hope you have a fabulous rest of your day. And remember, today is a good day. To have a good day. See you later.